the richest man in Babylon. The richest man in Babylon. Now, I know that you want to be financially free. Some want to be rich. Some do not want to be rich. But I know that everybody wants to be financially free. Not only financially free today, but financially free for as long as you live. So today I bring a book review for the book, The Richest Man in Babylon. It's a classic on personal finance written by George S. Clason in 1926. In 1926, he wrote this book. Now, the book mainly touches on seven cures or rules of money, seven cures or rules of money, and also it has got the five laws of gold. In other words, how do you protect money after you have accumulated it? Now, in this book, there is a fictional Babylonian character called Akkad, who was a scribe. When he started off, he was a poor guy, but as time went on, because he obeyed the rules of money or the seven cues of money, he became rich. So you want to be rich, there is what to do. Learn from the rich. All right? So let's look at the seven cues for a lean purse. Seven cues for a lean purse, or somebody could call these the seven rules of money, seven rules of financial freedom. Number one, the first cure. Start thy purse to fattening. Start thy purse to fattening. Akkad advises you and me to save 10% of our annual income. 10% minimum. Barest minimum is 10%. He says, for every 10 coins thou placest within thy purse, take out for use but 9. Thy purse will start to fatten at once, and its increasing weight will feel good in thy hand and bring satisfaction to thy soul. In other words, Akkad is teaching us here is that if you want to be successful financially, if you want to be financially free, the first thing you need to do is to make sure for every money that comes to you, make sure you save a minimum of 10%. Some save 20%, some save 30%, some save 40%. Make it a rule. You don't save when you feel like saving. You don't save when somebody tells you to save. You make it a rule for yourself. No matter what happens, you save 10%. Number two cure is control thy expenditures. Control thy expenditures. Akkad advises against luxury expenditures that ultimately become confused as necessities. The gold we may retain from our earnings is but the start. All right? So, in other words, we are learning from this book as the second cure or the second rule of money is that if you don't know how to keep your expenses at a minimum, whether as an individual or as an organization, you are definitely going to sink. Yes, you may have done the first one very well. You are saving 10%. But then if your expenditure goes beyond the roof, then you are doomed. We see this happening not only among individuals, but it happens among organizations, and the organization ends up, you know, folding up, closing. We also see this among governments. There are government departments or governments in general that spend more than they are supposed to spend. They spend beyond the budget. This is not good. So the second cure is control thy expenditures. Number three. Make thy gold multiply. Make thy gold multiply. So in this one, we are taught to respect the power of compound interest. Yes, you have earned. Saving is not good enough. Putting money in the bank is not good enough, because at the end of the day, it can be eroded by inflation. So it's important for you to learn to multiply your gold, multiply your money. Find an investment to put your money in. That's number three. Number four, guard thy treasures from loss. Guard thy treasures from loss. Akkad advises against taking a risk of loss and investing in get-rich-quick schemes. I think you know quite a lot of people who easily fall for get-rich-quick schemes or Ponzi schemes because they want to be rich quickly. But according to this book, The Richest Man in Babylon is teaching us that learn to be patient, never lose your money. As Warren Buffett once said, three rules of money. Number one, never lose money. Number two, never lose money. Number three, never lose money. It's important. Once you have made money and you have saved some and you are growing the pot, now the next thing is guard against losses. All right? And then number five, make of thy dwelling a profitable investment. Make of thy dwelling a profitable investment. In this book now, we are advised that it's more important for you to buy a property rather than renting. I know this one is a very controversial one. Some people don't believe in buying a property to stay in. They believe in renting. You will do your own due diligence on this one. But according to the book, The Richest Man in Babylon, the idea really is to say that money you are paying for rent every month, you are actually making your landlord richer. Why don't you pay for a mortgage and actually own the house? All right? And then number six, ensure a future income. Ensure a future income. That's number six cure. What are we saying here? What the book is telling us is that it's important for you to think about tomorrow. Don't just eat everything today. Don't consume all your earnings today. Remember to keep some money for pension. Remember to keep some retirement income. Now, I always say to people, all of us have never been old, so we don't know how it feels to be old. But one thing for sure, I'm sure we have seen some old people here and there. Some of them are living well, some are not living well. When you grow older, you tend to also lose your health. Sometimes you lose your eyesight. It means it's actually more expensive to be old. So if you are young today and you are healthy and you are earning a lot of money, or whatever amount of money you are earning, and you are not doing anything about it, you are not keeping anything for your future, you are saying literally that you don't care about the suffering that will come to you when you are old. And of course, number seven, increase thy ability to earn. The book The Richest Man in Babylon teaches us seventh Q, increase thy ability to earn. In other words, if you are going to continue making money, if you are going to earn more money, then you must gather new skills. Upskill yourself. Increase your skills, increase your competencies, increase your knowledge. That's the only way you can be sure that as you grow, you will make more money and save more money. Now, I will go over them again. Number one, it says, start thy pace to fattening, which means save minimum 10% from your salary or from your business, whatever it is. And then the second one is control thy expenditures. The third one is make thy gold multiply. In other words, invest. Some people will invest in property. Some people will invest in shares. Some people will invest in bonds. Some people will invest in a business. Some people will invest in different things. Choose what to invest in so that your money can grow. And number four, guard thy treasures from loss. And I was quoting there Warren Buffett, never lose money, never lose money, never lose money. And then the fifth one is make of thy dwelling a profitable investment. Make sure you own a house rather than renting for the rest of your life. I know some people that actually rent in hotels. They can stay in a hotel for a month and they are paying for themselves. That's not what the rich people normally do. Number six is ensure a future income. Ensure a future income. Keep something for retirement from your salary. All right. And then, of course, lastly, increase thy ability to earn. Upskill yourself. Go back to school. Go to seminars. Go to workshops. Read books. Learn new things that you didn't know so that you secure your future. The Richest Man in Babylon, book review with Dr. Wilbert Aramutoko. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. I hope you are going to give some comments. Which is the next book that you want me to review for you? And then in this book, The Richest Man in Babylon, what did I leave out that you would have wanted to be discussed? Thank you very much. God bless you. Love you.